this is Christina, the amputee OT. In this video, I will be showing you how a definitive prosthetic leg works. This is a definitive prosthetic leg, or a prosthesis. There are a number of different ways of attaching a residual limb or a stump to your prosthetic leg. Those different methods of attachment are called suspension. Back in the day, people used to suspend their residual limb in their socket via any number of metal or leather straps, but now we have a bunch of different ways in which we can do it. This ratchet you see here is part of a lock system called a proximal lock, which is made by Coyote. To take my leg off, I press this latch, which releases the ratchet strap, and then my leg comes off like this. The socket of a prosthetic is the part where your residual limb goes into. My socket, and most sockets these days, are made out of carbon fiber. The inside of my leg is made of carbon fiber too, but I had a print laminated on the inside, although you can't see it very well probably. Probably what you'll notice on the bottom instead of the laminated pattern on the inside are the pads that are in the bottom. This leg was actually made a little bit too long, and so I needed to add a pad in the bottom so that my leg wasn't just kind of floating out in the open. This is a one-way suction valve that lets the air out of the socket when I put my leg on, but doesn't let the air come back in. This is my friendship anklet, very essential, and this is the foot. A carbon fiber socket is individually tailored for each individual, so this socket is made just for me and it's custom made for my residual limb. The way they make these sockets is by taking a mold of my leg, then making a positive and laminating carbon fiber over it with vacuum lamination. Without my socket on, you can see that there's this ratchet strap attached to my leg, and I bet you are wondering how it's attached to my leg. This is a liner that fits over my residual limb, and the ratchet strap is glued on via this blue silicone flexible pad. To put a prosthetic leg on with the Coyote proximal lock, you have to make sure the lock is in the right position, which you sort of learn by feel. Then you add the appropriate number of socks to fill out the extra volume, because your leg changes volume throughout the day. Then you step down into your socket and it makes a cool ratchet sound. And now my leg is secure in place and won't come off. My prosthetist even built me a special insert for the end of the ratchet strap so that it's not flopping all over the place when I'm wearing my leg. This is a close-up shot of the ratchet strap so you can see more clearly how the proximal lock works. This is a Freedom Innovations Renegade All-Terrain Low-Profile Foot, which might not look like much on the outside, but I'm going to take off this foot shell and you'll be able to see what the foot looks like with the foot shell taken off. If you don't know what you're doing, I would not suggest taking your foot shell off of your foot. There are actually three parts to this foot. Here's what my foot looks like without the foot shell. Probably not what you thought, huh? You can't really tell, but this is actually a carbon fiber plate that goes on the bottom of the foot shell. You can see how it flexes when I put my weight on the heel and when I put my weight on the blade, the heel. Also see, if I lean to the left or the right, how the split toe compensates for inversion and eversion. And this is what the foot looks like when it's flexing when the foot shell is on. The foot that I have, the Freedom Innovations Renegade All-Terrain Low Profile, is a really cool foot. I tried on a couple of feet, including the College Park True Step, the Oser Variflex, the Freedom Innovations Renegade, and finally I decided on the Freedom Innovations Renegade All-Terrain because it has a split toe. It's a little more suited for a variety of activities, including regular walking, jogging, hiking, and even really extremely high impact activities. So pretty much just about any activity you can throw at this foot, I think that it will be well suited for that. And it's because of that that I chose this foot, because I like to do a lot of different activities and I wanted a foot that could basically do whatever I wanted. Even though this foot is good for jogging and running, it probably wouldn't be good for something like competition running. For that, you would get one of the specialized running blade feet. The Renegade All-Terrain comes in two profiles, a regular profile and a low profile. Mine is the low profile version of the foot because my residual limb is kind of long, and so I don't have a whole lot of ground clearance, and I needed the low profile version because the regular profile version wouldn't fit under my leg. I also like that the Renegade All-Terrain is really low maintenance. There's really not much of anything to maintain on this foot. You just have to make sure that you keep the foot shell clean and make sure that you don't get a lot of dirt or grime accumulating inside of it. But it doesn't have elastomers that wear out or things that need to be adjusted on it. It's just very much a foot. It's right there and it does everything. So thanks, Freedom Innovations, for making a foot that is well suited to my lifestyle. I appreciate it. The basic function of a prosthetic foot has not really changed since people started strapping wooden limbs to themselves, but the materials that are used have made prosthetics a lot lighter, a lot more flexible, a lot more longer lasting, and a lot more able to reproduce a person's natural gait. Even though this is my definitive prosthetic, that doesn't mean that my leg and thus my prosthetic are not going to go through a bunch of changes in the subsequent months and years. Probably I'll be going back to my prosthetist several more times to make adjustments to the inside of the socket, and my leg will actually continue to shrink as the years go by, although it won't shrink nearly as fast as it did in the first few months that I had my prosthetic leg. A lot of people have asked me if my prosthetic leg is heavy, and the answer is that it's actually pretty light. The socket itself weighs just about nothing, the foot weighs a couple of pounds, and when you round it all together in the whole package, it weighs right about 3 pounds, which is actually less than my meat leg. Alright guys, that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments section below. Don't forget to subscribe if you like, and see you later. Bye bye!